Hi, I'm Brian Trains, that guy you often see on BBC astronomy programmes, and I am here in this clearing, which is located in these woods, which you've probably never heard of, in the wilds of Wales. And I am here today to show you three amazing structures, which are located just behind me across that stream. Now, these three structures are thought to be shelters, and these shelters are thought to be resting places for the early descendants of our human species. Now, I'm going to have a quick look at them and show you all the different types that there are. This is one of the first structures that we found. This is a sort of tent, which looks like it could fit around 5 people. In reality, it can only fit about 1 person comfortably, but you could quite easily fit an entire family here. It is rather cozy, actually. It's built by logs and twigs and sticks and ferns of all things. It's even got ferns on the floor here. Those old leaves. Let's go and try and find our second shelter. It seems we have found our second shelter. Now this one seems to fit 1 person comfortably again, but you could quite easily fit a couple here. Like with the last shelter, it is built using twigs and logs and sticks. It doesn't have much of a floor apart from dirt, and it has got a roof, again, made of ferns. Very interesting to see. Let's see if we can find our third and final structure. We've now arrived at our third and final structure. Now this looks like to be some sort of jail, as there's quite a lot of bars here, a lot of logs and twigs and sticks to keep inmates most likely inside. Now one of the walls is here is made out of mud and soil, which is the remnants of a fallen tree, showing their initiative in technology. The floor looks like it's made out of the leftovers of the roof, because there's moss and fern again. The moss is also good waterproof material to make roofs out of. Also on the floor here, we have these sycamore leaves. Now these would have been used to help keep the inmates off the Carney Woods, the Welsh grounds, so that would have been particularly handy. There's also here this guard staff, which I'm sure is worth £2.5 million. So I'm going to take this home to become guardian of the woods.